Jupiter Media presents. Avasar, telecasting global opportunities.
Hello and namaste. Welcome to Avasar program. I'm your regular host Sunil Acharya, and program is Avasar, which is talking about educational news and views. We are providing you the fresh information of educational system of Nepal and abroad too. In this case, we are continuously telecasting different series focusing on study in India program. Today I'm going to talk about Dayananda Sagar University, which is a private university established in 2014. It is located in Bangalore, the garden city and IT hub of India. The university is ranked fourth among new university by Karnataka rating framework KSURF and top rank in international collegiate program contest ICPC. Dayananda Sagar University has also received the Best Private University South Award by ASSOCHAM. It offers wide range of courses on undergraduate and postgraduate program focusing on technology, pharmacy, management, computer applications, science, arts, physiotherapy, etc. Dayananda Sagar University is also offering the PhD program at research level. To have the clear picture of Dayananda Sagar University, we have with Professor K.N.B. Murthy. Professor K.N.B. Murthy is currently the professor of CSC and Vice Chancellor of Dayananda Sagar University, Bangalore. He has vast experience on academia and holds PhD in computer science and engineering from IIT Madras. He has currently a member of Karnataka State Higher Education Council and the Academic Senate member of IIIT Bangalore too. Let's welcome him. Professor K.N.B., you are welcome on our show.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
So first of all, would you please elaborate something about Dayananda Sagar University?
Yeah, Dayananda Sagar University is a state private university approved by Government of Karnataka and also the University Grants Commission, New Delhi. This university is a university which offers programs in about six schools: School of Engineering, School of Medicine, School of Applied and Applied Science, then School of Humanities, the School of Management, and several others.
How does Dayananda Sagar University delivering globally standard education in India?
Yeah, as far as the education, higher education is concerned, it is going through a tremendous transformation in the recent years, because the education, higher education in the past and the higher education today is completely different for a variety of reasons. One of the reasons is that there's a lot of technology evolution or intervention happening in every walk of life. Therefore, it's necessary for the present students to have some background in technology in every program that they're going to study. That's point number one. Point number two, it's also equally important for the present students to understand certain skills. Apart from the conceptual knowledge, few skills are going to be critical, which we normally call as four C's. C, the first C is the communication. Therefore, the communication of the present children must be really good. The second C is the collaboration, where they must be in a position to work in a team and contribute in a team. The third is the critical thinking, means given a problem, how do they solve that problem in a creative way, in a different way? That's going to be the other skill that's required. The last thing is with regard to the creativity. How creative you are is going to be the key that's required. These are the four kinds of skills that are required. Of course, all these four C's have to have one more C, which is called as curiosity. You also need to keep the curiosity intact so that you can solve a new set of problems. Most importantly, the present-day education has to cater to the needs of the globe, because the global competition is going to be there. Therefore, the opportunities are going to be available across the globe. Therefore, the students must be globally competent. Therefore, it's necessary for them to be prepared for that kind of situation. Dayananda Sagar University is designing everything, incorporating these components which I mentioned. One is a global competence, and they also need to have some background in technology in every program of study they're going to they are going to do in dinosaur girls. That's a critical thing. Because coming to the next point, there are four important aspects which need to be considered in higher education. The first aspect is the curriculum design. What is the kind of curriculum that's being designed? It must be contextually relevant, because the present day curriculum must be far different from what we had earlier. Therefore, it's necessary. The curriculum must be designed with the contextually relevant. Second, the teaching learning has to change. In the sense, the present day learning is far different from the learning that was there in the past. Therefore, incorporating the skills that I talked about, those kinds of things have to be looked into. The other thing also required is the what is called as the research orientation. The research orientation is basically to expose them to newer kind of problems. Therefore, we normally say, apart from acquiring the conceptual knowledge, you also need to get what is called as application of concepts. Therefore, that's also other thing which needs to be looked into. This exactly what is the basis for Dayanand Sagar University to teach or educate the children. That's what is being considered.
What are the popular courses at Dayanand Sagar University?
As far as the context is concerned, there are two different viewpoints. One viewpoint is, as far as the Indian context is concerned, majority of the programs are related to computer science and the computer science related courses. Whereas in the globe, all the courses are in great demand, but particularly the Indian context is IT related kind of things. Therefore, the computer science are the ones which are doing really well. Of course, the second level of programs are the next level of programs are the electronics and communication, then comes mechanical, then comes electrical, etc. The traditional engineering. The bottom line is that any program that a student is going to do needs to have the computer related background. Otherwise, the students will find it difficult in the future, because everywhere there's a technology component. Therefore, the computer science background becomes very important, particularly the new age technologies, that's AI and machine learning, that's artificial intelligence and machine learning, maybe IoT, maybe something like cybersecurity, data analytics, that's data science, then augmented reality, virtual reality, mixed reality, these kinds of things. These are the things which are used in every branch of engineering. As far as demand is concerned, computer and computer-related courses are the ones which are doing really, really well.
We have talked about the globally standard education and quality of education there in Dayanand Sagar University. Let's have a talk about physical facilities and infrastructure too. Students often sharing their experience with our report about International Student Service Center facilities of institute, learning environment and research too. In this context, how Dayanand Sagar University is supporting international students?
So Dayanand Sagar University is concerned, it's a university which started about 5 years back. We have good number of students coming from few countries. Particularly, we find students in the School of Allied Health Sciences, particularly the programs like nursing and pharmacy. Then we also have few students in basic and applied science. There's also engineering, also few students are joined. And as far as this thing is, we also have the international admissions office. The admissions office has a small wing. There's one person who is looking after the international students, particularly talking to them, finding out their comforts, their kind of facilities they want. Facilitating an international student is one thing which is being taken care of. The second thing that's also being taken care of is we have an international hostel, a hostel for the students to stay. And the third thing that we also see is that help them out to get used to the culture, because whenever they travel from one place to other place, they take little time for getting used to the new environment. I think the international office or the a division in the admission section would handle that also, and also help them out. And we also arrange some get-togethers for the students from other international countries, studying in other schools also, maybe the other colleges. We will also do that kind of a thing so that they feel at home. The most important thing is they need to be very comfortable to excel in their studies. I think by and large, students who come from Nepal, they get into the system quite well. They start doing really well. I think they need a little bit of support in initial stages for coping with the kind of education here. I think that's all being done by the international office, the division, the admission section, and also the faculty are going to help them out in that regard. I see Dayanand University is going to scale up, and we are in the process of setting up what is called as Office of International Relations, an exclusive office which will expand in the years to come.
What is your experience with Nepalese students? Are they doing well?
Yeah, majority of them do well. I think a few students may need a little bit of the initial handholding. After that, they are doing really, really well. Coming to adjustment to the environment, they quickly settle down. I think they are really friendly with the Indian students. I don't see any major problems with Nepali students getting used to the Indian conditions and the Indian kind of education. I think one or two may require a little bit of support, which Dayanand Sagar can provide. I don't see any problem at all. They are doing really, really well.
During our journey program, we are talking with international students and Nepali students, and among international communities, Nepali students are doing very well, and they are grabbing opportunities and climbing different scholarships too. Does your Dayanand Sagar University offer scholarship to international students?
A merit basis, as few scholarships are being offered. Few scholarships are available, yes.
How do you help international students in this COVID pandemic?
As for the COVID situation is concerned, it started somewhere in the month of March, then where March 2020. At that point of time, the entire world was taken by storm because there was lockdowns, there were a lot of other things. What we did at Dayanand Sagar University is we had hostels. Immediately, we told all the students to be in-house for some time. Then we spoke to the authorities of the government and others to ensure that these students are flown back to their native countries for some time. Then we also told them the classes will be online for some time. Once the situation improves, probably we start getting them back to the campus. As of now, the classes are going online. This year, I think now in the month of October 2021, the offline classes have started. We have indicated to all the students that if they are comfortable coming to Bangalore, where the things are pretty stable now, they can come down. Or if they want to take a little more time, the online classes will continue to happen till the end of December. Once the entire environment is conducive, they can come back and resume the offline classes. As for the COVID period is concerned, we ensure that the students are very comfortable with regard to their stay, going back to their native place, online classes, the exams were online, the results were declared online. I think we were also in touch with the students regularly by writing to them if there are any issues that we need to handle. And we also helped them with regard to the psychological stress they had any. I think we ensure that everything is comfortable. And the last thing that we also did is few people did not take up few exams on account of the connectivity and other issues. We organized a different set of exams for those students to ensure that they are comfortable and complete their academic programs. One of the great things that happened at Dayanand Sagar University is that they could complete the entire thing as per the calendar, because there was a calendar laid out. Though there's a COVID situation, none of the academic calendars were affected. We switched over from offline to online, then conducted the examinations. Everything was done, and all the students were quite happy because they got their degree certificates, everything online, without any disruption in their academic programs as per se. As far as the education is concerned, we do the education in two or three different ways. For example, if you take any program of study, there's a set of courses. For each course, there is some what are called as the tool component, practicals, because experiential learning becomes very, very critical. That's exactly what I mentioned at the beginning. It's extremely important for students to acquire the new age skills. Therefore, it's also need to have a kind of collaboration with the industry. What we have done at Dayanand Sagar University is we have set up about 10 centers of excellence jointly with the industry, where the students would go to these labs for their practical training so that they're learning everything to the requirements of the industry. That's point number one. Point number two, the education is, as I mentioned at the beginning, it's globally relevant kind of education needs to be given by every institution today so that the students stand to get their placement in the reputed and good international companies. Therefore, there are requirements. Therefore, we also looked at the communication, collaboration, these kinds of components. Thereby, the students are completely ready to handle the problems or the industry environments anywhere in the globe. The last component is we also have collaboration with a good number of universities. To mention a few, we have an association with Illinois University of Technology, Institute of Technology, Chicago. We have a collaboration with them. We have a collaboration with the University of Texas, USA, the Arlington, USA. We have a University of North Texas. We have a collaboration with them, Denton, USA. We have Amist University, Malaysia. We also have Cyberjaya University, College of Medical Sciences. We have Indiana University, Purdue, that IUPUI is the university. And we also have a collaboration with few other universities in the UK for the students to do their internships and come back. What we normally do is the entire education will split into about three components. The first component is the learning that's going to happen in the classroom in the college. The second one is the industry internships. The third one is an internship in the universities abroad where they have an international exposure before they graduate. Thereby, the students are completely ready to take up placement or job in any of the countries without any difficulty. That's what we normally do in Dayanand Sagar University.
Again, talking about the quality of education, to deliver quality of education, how does Dayanand Sagar University is collaborating with other universities and industry?
Dayanand Sagar University is a part of Dayanand Sagar group of institutions, which has a legacy of 60 years. We have close to about 80,000 to 100,000 people, alumni, working in various organizations. You name any company, there are students from Dayanand Sagar group, and Dayanand Sagar College of Engineering, Dayanand Sagar University, and things of that type. Therefore, Dayanand Sagar group is well known in the Karnataka state and also in the country, and good number of students also done their masters and PhD from top universities in the world. I think as far as the name is concerned, there's no doubts, it's one of the reputed brands in the education sector. Dayanand Sagar University, though it started in 2015 as a university, but it has a legacy of 60 years of Dayanand Sagar group. I don't see any major problem as far as the name and brand is concerned. It's one of the best brands in the field of education.
Thank you, Professor K.N.B. Murthy. We are at the end of this session. What is your final message to the prospective student and parents, those who are trying to choose the best institution in India?
Yeah, as far as the education is concerned, normally we need to look at two or three important things as far as the parents are concerned. The first important thing they need to look at is what the future is going to be, how the world is going to look like 4 years down the line or 5 years down the line. That's one thing needs to be looked at. In the sense, how the job scenario is going to be, how the world is going to be, what are the kind of skills required, what are the kind of opportunities that are going to be there. That's what they need to look at. The second thing they need to look at is what are the career paths the students are looking for? What kind of career path? Is it a job in the industry? Is it to become an entrepreneur? or is it to continue the research, or you want to get into social service, things are type. Therefore, you need to make a list of the career paths the students are looking at. Then they need to look at what is called a program study, which program would give them the kind of career path they are looking at. And in a scenario which is going to be present 4 years down the line, that's the thing. The last thing they need to look at is which institution. Any institution which has understood the new age kind of requirements is the institute they need to look for. And I'm extremely happy to tell you that Dayanand Sagar University is one such university which has understood the market quite well. It has understood the future requirements and the industry requirements. Therefore, the entire design of curriculum, the academics at Dayanand Sagar University is to provide opportunities or provide the environments for the students to study and excel. And extremely happy to tell you, Dayanand Sagar University is a multidisciplinary university. It's not a single discipline. We have engineering, medicine, etc. The students of engineering also interact with School of Medicine. Students of applied and basic sciences interact with engineering. Therefore, any student who is going to do a program of study, for example, basic science, he will also do a course in engineering, School of Engineering, can also do a course in School of Medicine, can also do a course in design. We also have the opportunity to do a dual kind of programs. For example, a student can do a major in engineering and minor in law. A student can do a major in science and a minor in computer science. These kinds of opportunities are plenty. I think the right kind of education is going to be offered at Dayanand Sagar University, which has understood all the requirements of the current the job scenario, thereby imparts the best quality education required for the students to excel. Welcome the students of students from Nepal to join Dayanand Sagar University. We will facilitate and ensure that their stay here is going to be purposeful and useful.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you.
Awasar, telecasting global opportunities.